Finally, it's out the official OxygenOS Pie update for OnePlus 5 and 5T. For now, it's still open beta, and if you're running the latest open beta ROM like OB21 on OP5 and OB19 on 5T, then you should have already got the Pie update notification. It's an update for a newer Android version, so it's a full ROM, and the update size is 1775 MB. If you check the changelog, it says changes to the system with Android Pie with no more security patch and Pie gestures, but sadly the Pie gesture support is only for 5T. Next, new D&D mode and some other regular stuff. So you can download it via normal OTA method, or you can download the full ROM, place it in the internal storage of your phone, then go to settings, system update from system, gear icon, local upgrade, pick the file you just transferred and hit upgrade now. One good thing about the OxygenOS Pie upgrade process is that the same local upgrade process works fine even if you are running the Pie version of HydrogenOS. So if you had recently flashed the H2OS Pie, then transfer OxygenOS Pie ROM to your phone and use local upgrade method. So the process is done downloading and rebooting. Let's go to settings about phone. It's open beta 20 based on OxygenOS. Going to Android version tab, as you can see it is Android Pie with number 1 security patch and the build date is December 5. About the features, the launcher version you get with the ROM is 3.1.4. Now the app drawer customizations are under launcher settings, and dark theme applies for OnePlus shelf when the phone's UI is set to dark. New quick toggles and notification panel, they look the same but the toggles are circular now. Pie supports advanced control of notifications. You can restrict the notifications to only certain sections, and under apps and notifications, notifications, here you can turn off the notifications for unnecessary apps. There is no do not disturb mode, the same one we had seen before that controls behavior of sound, adding exceptions to calls, messages and events, but digital well-being is missing here as it is an exclusive feature for Pixel and Android One phones. Under display tab, we have the new adaptive brightness, which learns your usage by following how you change the brightness in different scenarios, and then it tries to replicate the same. So for effective results, it might take a week or two for the adaptive brightness to learn your usage patterns. Next, under battery tab, you have adaptive battery. When turned on, it observes what apps you use frequently and makes sure they stay in the memory while adding limitations for apps you don't use often. Also, you have the new auto battery saver mode, and now you can set it to turn on at any percentage from 5% to 75%. Next, new Pie gestures. If you go to buttons and gestures tab, navigation bar and gestures, here now OnePlus replaced the hide the navigation bar option with swipe up on home button. So with this new nav bar, you only have the home pill, and when you go to any app screen, then the back button appears to its left. To the right of the home pill, we have empty space, which you can fill it with the most useful feature of Pie, the accessibility menu. To enable this menu, go to settings, system, accessibility, accessibility menu under downloaded services and enable use service option. As you can see now, there's a tiny human shaped icon on the navigation bar. This is the accessibility menu that can take screenshots, and it can also trigger a couple of things like volume slider, power menu, recent apps, quick settings notifications and Google Assistant. So back to Pie gestures, when you swipe up, you get the new recents menu. You can slide the open tabs right or left to access all of them. We have clear all button below the open tabs. The home pill can be used as a slider to switch between the open tabs. And for split screen mode, hit the 3-dot menu on any supported app tab and select split screen. And about the other gestures, you can turn on the camera by pressing power button twice, quick activate assistant app by holding the power button for 0.5 seconds and about 3 seconds or more for power menu. Next, swipe fingerprint for notifications and long press the FP sensor to take a photo. Next, alert slider UI is new and the functionality of alert slider is changed too. Now it's total silence, vibration only and all sounds allowed. About the power menu, now we can add additional options to it. For one, lockdown mode, which you can find under security and lock screen, lock screen preferences. So this mode locks the screen and turns off smart lock, FP unlock and notifications from the lock screen. Next, you can also add advanced reboot options to the power menu. So for this, first you need to enable developer options by tapping the bell number multiple times under about phone tab, and next go to system tab, developer options and toggle advanced reboot. Next, with Android Pie, you can rotate any app screen without the usage of auto rotate toggle. With auto rotate turned off, just flip your device horizontally or vertically, and then you'll see this tiny rotate icon right next to the home pill. Tap it once to change the app orientation to horizontal or vertical, then flip your device again and hit the rotate icon to get back to the base orientation state. Next, with Android Pie, you can pair up to 5 Bluetooth devices at a time instead of 2 from Oreo 8.1, and now OP has added audio tuner support for Type-C and Bluetooth earphones. Next, you have the new magnifying glass feature when you highlight a text. And let's say you have highlighted a particular text which contains phone number or web page, the system automatically recognizes the text type and shows relevant app action. Next, you can turn off hotspot automatically after 5 minutes with no devices connected. Same utilities tab, you have gaming mode, parallel apps, app locker, schedule power on or off, pocket mode and OnePlus switch, but OP has added more supported apps for parallel apps. So that's it regarding the features about what's working and not with the ROM. Calls have no issues, Vivo LTE works but no dual 4G. No problems with FP or face unlocking. The camera app is the same, nothing changed. New camera app version is 3.0.8 and there is no nightscape mode. Camera 2 API is enabled just like H2OS ROM. It's level 3 and 1 pixel 3 port I tried worked for everything except front portrait mode. The one issue with this ROM is that it doesn't pass safety net check. As you can see, the CTS profile is failed and this device is not certified status under Google Play Store. I've tried clearing Google Play services and Play Store app data but didn't work. Maybe a factory reset is needed. About benchmarks, it is 2,4,584 with Antutu version 7. Geekbench 4 single core and multi core scores are 1949 and 6729. So that's it for now, the official OxygenOS Pie update for OnePlus 5 and 5T. If you have any questions, drop a comment. Thanks for watching. I'll see you guys soon.